Hello again, viewers. We're at the hotel Neros in Paphos, Cyprus. I've done a few videos showing you inside the room. If you remember, I'll leave a link at the end if you want to check out my room. Quite enjoyed my stay here. Nice, wee, friendly hotel. Great location. I've just realised I didn't film the swimming pool area or inside, so I thought I'd show you a wee bit inside the hotel and we'll walk down to the front and I'll show you how good the location is. Let's go. There's a guy inside playing the piano who's absolutely brilliant. I didn't even know they had a piano inside. It's only a wee basic, I think it's a 3-star hotel, but it's done the job for me. Plenty of sunbeds, swimming pool area is quite nice. I've not been in the pool, so I couldn't tell you what it's like, but it looks quite nice. Filmed about midday, so it gets the sun, as you can see. It's a wee outdoor bit. Check this wee cool bike. Paid £54 for a room in here last night, and that was a double room, so effectively it was the same price for two people as it was for one. Looks as if that's some sort of hoist they've got as well, maybe help people in, not sure, or it could just be like a parasol. Yeah, I'm not sure, could just be a parasol to keep the sun off. This guy is brilliant on the piano. So we come for breakfast and they've got the bar. I didn't have any food in here, so I can't comment on the food. But this is basically where you come for breakfast. We've got Keo on draft. I did a pint of that last night in the Baywatch bar. Quite a nice beer, quite liked it. So it's a buffet breakfast. I think it was roughly about 10 euros extra for breakfast. I didn't go for it because I wasn't sure if I was going to make it in time. It's quite a nice wee restaurant. As I said, I can't really comment on the food because I didn't have any food in here. But the hotel itself has been perfectly fine. Check the wee selection of wines I've got here as well. Guy in the piano is brilliant. I could sit here after and listen to him. Unfortunately, I need to crack on the videos. Let's head outside. I'll show you exactly where it's located. So, looks as if we've got a wee TV kind of area here as well, maybe showing the football and stuff like that as well. First time I'm around here. Guy's brilliant on the piano, isn't he? Oh, look at this. We've got a wee games room in here, didn't even know this was here either. Let's continue. Okay, it's just a wee pool table, table football. That game there as well, very kind of old fashioned. We've got a wee poker set there as well. So we'll go outside, check out this, the bike and the ball. It's pretty cool. So this is basically where you come for breakfast, the guy on the piano, brilliant. Superb. We've got a wee library area here as well. What kind of books have they got? Viewers, let's have a wee look and see. Joan Nesbo. Oh, quite a good selection. Waddington's shaped jig mat. CYPRUS, eh? There you go. Scrabble as well. So it looks like we've got another wee bit through here as well. Okay, you can get a wee coffee and stuff there as well. It's not bad for a wee 3-star hotel. I mean, it's no frills. The rooms are basic, but location is brilliant. Staff are lovely. It's got all the facilities you'd need, really. Can't really complain. Let's head outside. Okay, so this just brings us out onto the kind of main road. Now, ended up getting a taxi here. That was another story which I did cover in the video. Check out the video I've done, the first one I've done here. Anyway, taxi came in from this side and I was speaking to the girl at reception. I says, can I walk into the town to get the bus to Limassol? And she's like, nah, 45 minute walk, kind of up the hill, up that way. It's not really been up this way yet. So a taxi basically brought me in this way. I think there's another bar up here, let me just check and see. And we'll head back down the way, I'll show you the location. So you can see there's a kind of busy main road at the end here, but we're going to go back down the other way. I just want to see what's here. Oh, okay, there's a bar here called Mikey's. The guy in reception did mention this bar last night, they do all the live sports and everything as well. There's loads of sports bars around here. You won't struggle to find a bar to watch football, that's for sure. So that's Mikey's there. Okay, we're going to head back down the way. So, let me know, viewers. It's about 25 degrees, I'd say already midday. It's pretty hot actually. Wee bit of wind, but lovely weather. Definitely hotter than Naples where I was 2 days ago. Naples was about 20 degrees, but quite windy. And then at night it got a lot colder. Here is about 4 or 5 degrees higher temperature than the south of Italy, judging on just, you know, when I've came in May. Let me know, has anybody stayed in that hotel? Would you recommend it? I know I've got a couple of viewers who left comments saying that they have stayed there before. I don't really have any complaints about it. It's a basic 3-star hotel in a great location. I'll just show you the location. Now, they've also got something that's very, very handy. 24-hour supermarket just next to us here. That Chinese last night, it shut quite early. I was thinking of going in there, but it shut, I think, about 10 o'clock. I've got Lofty's bar on the left-hand side here. They had a live singer on last night. So that's Lofty's. Looks as if it's maybe just opened. And now, this is the wee 24-hour supermarket, which is always brilliant to have. The guy's really friendly in there. I went in, I bought a couple of things last night, and let's say the change was 20-30 cents. I just says to the guy, keep the change, and he's just like, thanks, I appreciate that. Just really nice and friendly. And when I went in, he just said, hello, how you doing? Just basic stuff, which you'll not believe not many people do. The meeting pub is quite a busy place during the day, as far as I can see. It was busy yesterday during the day, and then it was shut quite early at night. Alexander's is round there. I've mentioned that in my other video when I went in to watch the St Mirren game. Did not end well. But a cracking bar for watching the football. Here is a 24-hour supermarket. I got toothpaste in here this morning. They sell everything you'll need. I'm going to try and see if I can get a plug adapter in here as well, because I had to borrow one from the hotel. Check out the caps. Maybe I should have got one of these wee CYPRUS caps. Island vibes. Very nice. That one there. Nice as well. So at this point, you've got a decision to make, viewers. You can head straight down here, or you can go right, and there's quite a few bars and restaurants down there as well. We'll just walk down this way by you. Just in case you've missed any of my previous videos, I'll show you where it is. So the meeting pub there's got the TVs outside as well, they're doing breakfast. Got Steakhouse Restaurant. Friends Bar had a very, very good singer on last night, a girl. And she finished quite early because the Eurovision Song Contest was on, and everybody started watching that. So I decided to go across the road because they still had a live singer on. The girl was on The Voice in Greece and nearly got to the final. She got through 5 rounds, and she was pretty good. And it was a lovely bar in here. I was speaking to the owners, and quite an interesting, really just kind of learn about it. A very good sound system in this bar. I'm just coming up to Baywatch. I mentioned that to the owner, and he's like, thanks for noticing. I says, I could not help but notice. It was that good, the sound system. When the singer was on, and then they changed it, they put the Eurovision Song Contest on, I felt as if I was there. Okay, so I've got some more restaurants and bars around the corner there as well. Again, this Indian restaurant is at Gianta. It was very, very busy last night. And it shut early. It was about 10:30, I think, maybe, and it completely shut. So if you're going out for a meal here, don't think you can just walk in at midnight. A lot of these places shut a reasonably early time. We'll just have a walk by the Baywatch bar. Let me see, I'm getting lost here again. So maybe just down here. Ah, it's just down here, okay. Robin Hood pub. This was the busiest bar last night, and everywhere, I couldn't even get a table in here. If I was thinking of going in there, they had Cypriot traditional music on. Really, really busy, good atmosphere, a lot of families in as well. People up dancing, it's pretty good. Other Indians there, the Delegate, where I did actually have a wee curry in there, and I listened to the traditional Cypriot music. So for all the guys who complain I'm not embracing local culture, I get the best of both worlds, a wee curry. I got to listen to the music. I don't think I would have got a table in there, it was so busy. So we'll probably go for some Cypriot food later on today. If you watch all my videos in Tenerife and Spain, you'll see quite often I have tapas. A few people complaining, oh, why go to Cyprus and eat this, and why go to Cyprus and watch the football. I don't really know why people bother, to be honest with you, but I'm doing another video about that, we'll talk about it. Flintstones bar. Yabba dabba do. I think we did walk by the Bahamas bar actually. No, the Baywatch bar, sorry. Not the Bahamas bar, the Baywatch bar. So, you see, I've showed it in another video, we check it out. Yeah, Flintstones bar's really nice inside. That was busy last night, a lot of people were in it. That's another very central hotel there, the Dionysus. Don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but anyway, there's quite a lot of hotels that are very, very good locations here, close to everything. But you can see how close we are to the promenade and the beachfront down here. I'm quite annoyed I didn't show you the Baywatch bar there, sorry, I don't know how I missed it. But I have got other videos showing you. So if you come here, that's a bar I recommend. It's lovely inside, you can see they spent a lot of money on it. This bar in the corner, a restaurant, it's been busy ever since I've been here. Day and night, it's always busy, this one in the corner. Across the road here, you've got kind of chains, Pizza Hut, Cafe Nero, you've got a Donald Express as well. So you've got quite a good mix of everything here. Traditional, separate restaurants, Indian, Chinese, chains, something for everybody here. That is the cafe that's been the busiest every time I've been here. Every time I pass it, it's always got people in it. Oh, it's, I tell you, it's a lot busier during the day than it is last night. I'll probably do a wee walk to the marina just because it's a lot busier today. Done a wee walk to the marina last night, but it was quite late, it was about 10 o'clock, it wasn't that busy. Looks a lot busier here today. Nice down here, eh, viewers? So you can see how good the location this hotel is. Under 10 minutes, not even that, and I've been taking my time, walk slowly, and we're right down here. Not been down there yet, so we'll see if I maybe make it down there later on. It's lovely here, isn't it? How nice is it? Yeah, I might take a wander down to the left here. We'll wait and see, viewers. Oh, so nice. Thank you.
Don't move just yet. Take your time.
Thank you.
Take your time.
Thank you.
Just take it easy.